morning. They said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. It's now time for our scripture and prayer. Our scripture reading will be coming from Psalm 24, verse 1 through 6, and then I will do a prayer. The earth is the Lord, and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein. For he hath founded upon the sea, and established it upon the flood. Who shall ascend unto the hills of the Lord, or who shall stand in this holy place? He that have a clean hand and a pure heart, who have not lifted up his soul unto vanity, nor swore deceitfully. He shall receive the blessing of the Lord and the righteousness from God of his salvation. This is the generation of them that seek him, that seek thy face, O Jacob. May the Lord add a blessing to the readers, hearers, and doers of his holy word. Let us bow our heads for a word of prayer this morning. Father God, we thank you for once again putting us on the wake-up list this morning. Lord, you woke us up. We had health and strength, and we had right mind. Lord, we thank you for covering us all night as we slept, as we slumped. We didn't even know that we existed in this present world. But Lord, you kept us, and you touched us, and you strengthened us. And Lord, we had our right mind. Lord, we can get up and go into our different restroom and relieve ourselves. We can get into our own shower and shower ourselves. We can go into our closet and pick and choose what we wanted to wear. We can even go into our different kitchen and choose what we want to eat. Lord, we bless you. Because, Lord, we know it don't have to be so, but just that you have allowed it to be so. Lord, we thank you that when you woke us up this morning, we was in our right mind. And, Lord, we had a mind to want it to be into the house of God this morning. And, Lord, when we came out, let us not leave the same way we came, but let us be filled as an empty pitcher before a full fountain. Lord, we bless you, we honor you, we thank you for this time and this word we're about to receive. We're asking all this in Jesus' mighty majestic name. Amen. Amen. And thank God.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Really quickly, can we worship together? Praise the Lord, everybody. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yeah. Praise the Lord, everybody. Yeah. Come on, if you can just lift up your hands to Jesus and tell the Lord thank you. Yeah. Do I got any grateful people? Yeah. Do I got anybody that really loves the Lord? Come on, y'all still looking at me. Do I got anybody that really loves the Lord? Yeah. The song says, I really love the Lord. Come on, anybody love him this morning? Oh, I really love the Lord. You don't know what he's done for me. Anybody believe it? He gave me the victory. I love him. I love him. I really love the Lord. Come on, can we sing it again? Say, if you love him this morning, can you lift it up with us this morning? Oh, I on. If y'all know it, just sing it with us. He gave me
the victory.
Oh, I love him.
Oh,
I love him. Come on, if you know it, just sing it with us. Oh, the song says, you don't know. Oh, you don't know. Come on now, has he blessed anybody else? Father, you gave me. Oh, I love. Oh, yes, I do. Come on, let your Lord just tell him. Lift up and tell him. Say, I really. Come on now, y'all want to lift it up with us. Oh, you don't know, you don't know. That sounds real good, St. Luke. Well, he gave me the victory. Has he given anybody the victory? Oh, Jesus, I love you. Jesus, I love you. Come on, one last time. Can we lift it up? Come on, we can just do it. Come on, we can be one big choir. Come on, let's hear the people sing it. You don't know. Father, you gave me. I love you, Jesus. I love the Lord. Come on now, if you love the Lord. Come on now, if you love the Lord. I said, if you love him. Oh, you don't know what he's done for me. Gave me the victory. See, I can have church all by myself. I love him. I love him. I really love the Lord. Come on, let me try one more time. You don't know what he's done for me. You got to look over yourself. Look over your life. He gave me. Gave me the victory. Some of y'all still sitting down like he ain't did nothing for you. You got to look up and tell him, Lord, I love him. Oh, I love him. You got to look at yourself and say, Come on and touch yourself and say, Come on, somebody can do it. Touch yourself and say, really love the Lord. Because God is able to do just what he said he would do. He's gonna fulfill every promise that he has for you. Listen, don't give up on God, 'cause he won't give up on you. Don't give up on God, 'cause he won't give up on you. He's able. God is able. God is able to do just what he said he would do. See God. Oh, oh.
Just what he said.
Come on, I like that, St. Luke. He's gonna fulfill every promise. Oh, yeah. Don't you give up on God. Everybody can say it. He's able. Oh, 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 oh. Put your hands together. Say he's able. Come on, y'all got it, St. Luke. Come on, can we take it from the top one more time? Oh, oh, oh. Sing God. Just what he said he would. God is going to do it just for you. Oh, he's gonna fulfill every promise that you have. Don't give up on God. Oh, everybody say,
yeah.
about you, but don't give up on God. If you've had a week like I have, I'm still leaning and depending on him. Don't give up on God. I don't know who I'm talking to, but somebody needs to hear that this morning. Don't give up on God. Don't give up on God. Cause he won't give up on you. Can I say it one more time? Last time. Oh, don't give up on God. Cause he won't give up on you. He's able. Come on now, if you believe God is able, if you believe it with your heart, God is able. God is able. God is able to do it. Whatever it is. Whatever it is. Whatever it is. Whatever it is. God is able. Oh, yeah. Jesus. Now we can sing about God being able. But if you really love him, can we call on Jesus? Anybody know God is on the main line? And you can tell him whatever you want. Can we have some church this morning? Say, yeah. Come on, if you stand to your feet, let's have some church this morning.
Call him up.
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 up and tell him what you want. Jesus is on the main line. We can call him and tell him exactly what we want. It is good to be here today. I said it is good to be here today. It is good to be here today. God is good to us. God has been great to us. I said it is good to be in this place. As we come and we worship our God in this place, we thank God for your presence here today. If it had not been for God on our side, I don't know where we would be. But it is good to be here as we come to worship today in the spirit and in truth. And it's just grateful for having you here today and those who are online. We are certainly grateful for you tuning in with us. And many I know is on vacation, but we thank God for you wherever you are. You can still tune in wherever you are today and worship with our God today. We thank God for the choir ministering to us in music. We thank God for them. But they cannot take your place. They cannot praise God for you. Because God has done something for you that he didn't do for them. So you ought to be able to praise God just for God. Amen. We praise God for Jesus Christ. We thank you this morning for this day of worship in this month, first Sunday in July. And we're grateful today that we can come today as part of our hug ministry this morning all over the building. You can move around and share the peace of God with somebody today as you love on someone as they worship in this place today. Can we do that today? It's a great time to do that. Amen. We'll be right back. worship as we worship in giving this morning, as brothers will come as we do this very swiftly and move forward with this experience of worship this morning. Amen. Gilify is certainly a part of giving, and many of you have probably already used Gilify, or you can do it online. It takes you about 2 minutes. Take you a minute and a half. A minute and a half. It take even less to do $1,000. Less than a minute and a half. You can do it. You can do that real swift. Amen. Heads, God, we thank you for the gift and the giver. Bless what they have left in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. As we continue this morning remembering Miss Wallene Mosley. Wallene is in the hospital. We're certainly praying for her and Cassandra and the family today while she recuperates there. Praying for Yana Adao in the passing of her father. Praying for them on this today, and certainly praying for the Mitchell and Liddell families that we eulogized on yesterday. We praying for them, all those children, that God will help them get through the season. Praying also for Pam Merriweather this morning as we continue to lift them up in prayer on this day. Also, we're just grateful today as we come this morning to have our own member here. We're glad to have Aiden Hawkins here. Aiden is going to come and sing before I preach. Amen. Come on, give him a hand. He left being a young boy, now he a man. Grateful for Aiden going to bless us with music today. Amen. Amen. And on the music, he gonna sing also. He gonna do it. Come on now. What he need? Let me get out of the way so I won't upstage anything today. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Thank God today. We pray. praise God for Aiden today. And come on, give him a hand. Again. Hallelujah. When young men come back and honor God, we ought to praise God. Now, you can complain about all the negative stuff, but that's a positive. And I give God glory for it. We thank God because they are even more positive, just like him today, that they'll come and express themselves in music on today. Amen. I'm just excited about him being here today, and to Drayton Hawkins Sr. and Crystal. We're grateful for his parents. Amen. Amen. Doing great work in school in Oak Ridge High School in Oak Ridge, and we're just grateful for them taking that leap of faith and moving to an area that is unknown to them, but they are being made known in Oak Ridge, Tennessee. And we praise God for them on today, and certainly encouraging him as he moves forward. I think Aiden is, if he's not a senior, he ought to be real knocking on the door. He's a senior, so he's going to soon be graduating, going on to college. And I can just about, I can almost say what college he's going to go to. I can come real close to it. Real close to where he's going to attend college. But one thing I do know, he's going to attend. Amen. He's been prepared and a prime for to move and be successful in life. His dad, Drayton, a senior, will soon be finishing his doctorate, and we praise God for Drayton doing that work to become that in that educational field that he's been so great in. Amen. Amen. Praise God. I want to begin this series, Summer Breeze, through Psalms. Beginning on this morning, and we want to begin in Psalm 66 and verse 12. It will be our reading for the morning, for there'll be other scripture that you'll see possibly on the screen as well. We're going to begin in Psalm 66, the New Living Translation, in verse 12. Then you put a leader over us. We went through the fire and flood, but you brought us to a place of great abundance. Can we just read that together? Maybe we can get that. Then you put a leader over us. Went through the fire and flood, but you brought us to a place of great abundance. You may be seated. A word in season. A word in season. A word in season. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me. Spirit of the living God, fall on your people here today. In this season of our life, we come today to tell you thank you for this season. Thank you, God, for Jesus Christ. Thank you, God, for the Holy Spirit. This season is painful for some, but we're in a season of our lives that you're going to bring us through the fire, because we know the fire is just temporary. You're going to bring us through the water, because that's temporary also. But you're going to bring us into a wealthy place where we can be blessed of Almighty God. Thank you right now. We pray for Wallene Mosley today. We pray, God, for Mitchell and the Liddell family. We pray for Cal, and we pray for them as young boys, 10 years old and 8 years old. They have to live a life without their mom. But God, there are some here know that you'll be a mother for the motherless. And there are some know that you'll step in and bless their life. Bless Kristen today. Bless them today. God, give them strength. Bless Akaya today. Give them strength today. We'll be mindful, God, to love you even greater. In Jesus' name, amen. A word in season. What I want to say in this introduction of this conversation today is that what I would like to say is don't quit on the edge of your miracle. One more step can put you in the middle of your promised blessing. One more step. Because you're about to enter the greatest season of your life. I believe today that God is about to move in your family, in your business, in this church. God is about to make a move in your finances. In your own personal life, God is about to do and make a move in a greater way than you've ever experienced in the past. That's why I come today, to allow you to think with me today, to know that you're going into a season that you've never been in before. And I'm saying to you today, the first point I want to say is this. I got three, but they're going to sound the same. One is, you're standing on the edge of a breakthrough. Can y'all say this with me? You're standing on the edge of a breakthrough. Really, whether you're really at the edge of a miracle. You're right there. You're right at the edge of that miracle. And God is wanting to do something in this season of your life that you will reward you, not just now, but will also reward your family in the future. Because God wants you to experience something that you have not ever experienced before. Because you're at that edge. You're right there. And all you got to do is just trust God to go a little further. Just one step away from the greatest experience of your whole life. Matter of fact, it's Numbers 23:19. It says in Numbers, it said, God is not a man, so he does not lie. He's not human, so it does not change his mind. Has he ever spoken and failed to act? Well, let's see from you. Y'all gonna help me out. Now, that's a question. Has God ever said anything and failed to come through with it? Has he ever promised? Has he ever promised and not carried it through? I mean, in your own life, not in your own life. Has God ever told you anything and didn't act on it? Has he ever told you something, made a promise to you, and he did not carry it through? It is God who said, if you give, I give back to you. Haven't he kept his word? Come on now, in your own life, has he not kept his word that he said, if you only give just a small portion of what I bless you with, I'm going to open up the windows and give you greater blessings. He always carries through. Well, let me say this. While you may not have any evidence that a change is about to take place, you have confidence that he's an on-time God. Yes. You some rain at what you're preaching today, I have no evidence of my season in changing. But I tell you one thing, you ought to have a little confidence that God is an on-time God. Because you still believe if God said it, he would do it. If God spoke it, he'll bring it to pass. I still believe that. I really do with all my heart. I believe that if God said it's going to happen, it's going to happen exactly how he said it. So when you look at Numbers 23:19, you can write beside 23:19, that's a promise. That's a promise, Rick. That is a promise that, and I'll tell you one thing, if all you have is a promise, I got some good news for you. A promise is all you need. If all I got is a promise, then a promise is all I need. He doesn't need to tell me another thing because I believe everything that the Bible has said to me. If he promised it, it's going to come exactly like he promised. Well, come to Abraham and preach to us. Abraham, all Abraham had was a promise that he was going to have a son. He just promised him, I'm going to bless your seed. But Abraham is 100 years old. And nobody would even think about having a child at 100 years old. All I got is a promise. Sarah is 90. He's 100. And I'm promising you all going to have a son. But instead of him waiting on God, usually what we do is get ahead of God. And we try to help God out when God never needs your help. If he said it, he's going to do exactly what he said. So they went and go. He went on and had a child by Hagar. Y'all know this, don't you? But that was not the promise God gave him. But when they got to be 100 and she at 90, all of a sudden, oops, here come a boy. And his name going to be Isaac. His name means laughter. Because you laughed when I said what I was going to do. But I come today to tell somebody today, God got a promise with your name on it. You can sit here and laugh. You can sit here and poke fun at what I'm preaching. But I'm telling you right now, it's a word in season. It's a word in season. And I hear in my ear, Revelation 1:18 says, I am he that liveth and was dead. Behold, I'm alive forevermore. Amen. And he said, I got the keys of hell and also of death in my hand. So before I go any further this morning, since all I have is a promise, and if a promise is all I need, then I need to praise on a promise. Yeah. I need the crowd I had yesterday to say amen, because y'all a little too relaxed. I said, all I got is a promise. And if a promise is all I need, then I need to praise God on a promise. So I'm trying to get you to understand, you need to praise God on a promise. I don't have the blessing yet, but I'm praising you on a promise. I don't have a new house yet, but I'm praising you in advance that it's going to happen. I don't have my health back yet, but I'm praising you in advance that my health is just around the corner. Can I get an amen right there? Well, let me give y'all about 2 minutes. Just praise God on a promise. Praise God on a promise. I ain't got it, but I'm shouting anyway. You see, you may be having a hard time. And I know, I feel y'all, you may be having a hard time trying to figure out what's going on in the present time. And you're having a hard time with that. Because your mind is telling you one thing, and your spirit is telling you something else. Your mind is saying one thing, your spirit is saying another thing. The best way that I can word it is this, is your body is still in the present, but your spirit has stepped into your future. And your mind is confused because it's trying to figure out what's going on. Your mind is here, but your spirit is in the future. And I'm trying to figure out, Lord, I'm out of my mind. I done got confused because I'm confused about, Moraine is sitting here telling me that I'm in the present body and I don't see nothing he's saying. But my spirit is saying I already got it. My mind is saying it ain't going to ever happen. But my spirit says I got it in my hand. My body says I'll never make a millionaire, but my spirit says I'm already there. Wish I had somebody here. That God wants to do. God wants to do in you what you cannot do within yourself. Well, 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 9 and 10, they shall have it there very quickly. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 9 and 10, it said, that is what the scriptures mean when they say, no eye has seen, no ear has heard, no mind has even imagined what God has prepared for those who love him. Then verse 10 said, but it is to us that God revealed these things by the Spirit, for his Spirit searcheth out everything that shows us God's deepest secrets. Eye has not seen, my ear has not heard, neither have entered in my heart what God has in store for me. I shall never forget graduating once in the commencement service at Christian Brothers University. I shall never forget the commencement sermon that was given that day. And normally, when you're in a commencement service, you just really want to get out of the cap and gown. All you want to do is just turn that tassel. You don't even hear what they're talking about. And sometimes they don't even graduate him. I don't even go back. Just send my paper, and I'm cool. Just send my paper. But this time, somehow, I guess because it may have been, I don't know, it was a Christian school, so they had somebody probably was preaching, I guess. I don't know. But I did hear him, and it stuck with me to this day. I didn't know 1 Corinthians 2, 9, and 10. But when that dude got done, I put it in my spirit. Because what he was trying to tell all of the graduates, your eye has not seen, your ear has not heard what God has in store for every one of you. And I come to tell somebody today, you ain't seen nothing yet. You ain't heard nothing yet. I wish I had folk that came to church on the first Sunday morning in the July 4th celebration that came to celebrate that God, your eye hadn't seen. You can't even imagine what God about to do for your family, in this church, in your finances. God's about to blow you up like you've never been done before. So what I'm saying is, while your body is in your present, in your today, your spirit has stepped into your tomorrow. Just stepped into your mom, because what is happening today is there's a revival that's happening at St. Luke Church this morning. It's a restoration, and it's also a renewal. And I'm not going to let you all get out of here until y'all understand what I'm saying. Because the idea of you at the edge of your breakthrough, God is about to make some provision. Prosperity and your mind is confused, because you think all about prosperity is seeing it on TV, and you think it's just for certain folk. But when it comes down to the local church, we don't want to talk about prosperity. But who doesn't want to prosper? What believer don't want to prosper? Why you don't want to prosper? Why you don't want to have the best that God has for you? I'm saying today, brother deacons, you're at the edge of your breakthrough. Let me say this morning. This is why you cannot tolerate things you used to tolerate. Can I say that one more time for those in the back? That's you're at the edge of your breakthrough, and that's why you cannot tolerate things you used to tolerate. This is why you cannot tolerate certain people anymore. I'm going to preach anyway, y'all right? You're so close to your breakthrough that you don't have time for man's foolishness. You don't have time for drama. You don't have time for strife. And you don't have time for negative talk. Y'all ain't say, I ain't got time for it. I don't want to hear it, because I'm about to get my blessing. And I'm not going to hear your negative talk. As the season of your life, you cannot afford to have people in your life that's always talking negative. Okay, you can't afford it. You just can't afford to have folk in your life that don't talk nothing but negative talk. I'm too old for drama. I'm too old for foolishness. You know one thing? You are too. You too old for foolishness. You too old for being messy. Well, other words, this is it. Understand, you do not need people. You do not need people telling you that you cannot have what God says you can have. You do not need people telling you or that what God said you can do. You don't need people telling you to go where God said you could go. If God said I'm going, I'm going. If God said he's going to do it, I'm going to do it. You can be shaking all you want, but I'm going to tell you, I am a daredevil. And I would take a risk and don't know how I'm going to pay for the risk. But I've been successful by standing out there and not knowing everything in place. And sometimes that's where faith come in. You can't see your way all the way. Sometimes you got to trust God even when you can't trace God. Sometimes you got to stop coming to church and start believing what you believe at church. Can I have anybody on your roll? Matter of fact, don't talk to them. Talk to the person in your seat. And tell the person in your seat, I'm going to have what God said I'm going to have. I'm going to do what God said I'm going to do. I'm going to receive everything God has for me. Did you talk to the person in your seat? Did he scream back to you and say, come on, baby? Did he tell you, come on with it? I want it also. I got to have what you want me, because I hear the word to support what I'm saying is Philippians 4:13. So I can do all things through Christ that gives me strength. You got to understand, no matter what goes on in life, if you can do anything, it didn't say I can't, it said I can. It didn't say I hope so, I can. It didn't say it will be, I can do everything through Christ that gives me strength. You need people in your life that can believe in you. People who believe in your future. John Couch said, you need people in your life that celebrate you and not people who tolerate you. Yeah. You with the wrong person. You're the wrong person. You with somebody just tolerating you. I don't want to be with nobody just tolerating me. I want to have somebody that's going to celebrate me. Because if we're going to make a good life for each other, we need to high five each other. If I don't have it, she ought to have it. If she ain't got it, he ought to have it. Everybody working together to achieve a certain goal. It ought to be somebody at your house that said we're going to make it. It ought to be somebody saying, don't worry, it's going to be all right. It ought to be somebody on your road today that says it's going to be all right. You ain't got it, but it's going to be all right. Can y'all tell your neighbor today, it's going to be all right. It's a word in this season that God is going to do a blessing in your life. In your life. So my first point is what? What is the first point? Standing on the edge of your breakthrough. Well, my second point is this. Standing on the edge of your breakthrough. Y'all ain't got something. My second point is just like the first point. I'm standing on the edge of a breakthrough. And I tell you what, Veronica, why do you think hell is hitting you so hard? Why has there been an increase of demonic activity against you? Why do you think that's so much activity from the devil that's coming against your family and coming against your business? An increase of demonic activity is a sign that Satan has discovered your purpose. And you're on the verge of stepping into the greatest season of your life. Satan has peeped out your car. And he see in your hand, a blessing is in your hand. And when he see a blessing is about to take place in your family, he going to send activity from demonic areas to try to get you off track and try to get you from being what God wants you to be. But I'll tell you one thing, when the devil comes, you need to break out in praise. When the devil comes, you ought to break out into praise. As soon as he tries to enter into your realm of thinking, you ought to start praising God. I didn't say pray, I said praise. Because when you start praising God, the devil will step back and move back and move back. But what's wrong up in here today, this is July 4th weekend. And I know how y'all act on the 4th of July weekend. It ain't your day no way. Y'all done partied for the wrong reason. Y'all done celebrated on the wrong day. June 19th, some of y'all didn't do nothing. July 4th, y'all act a plum fool. But July 19th is the day you should have been celebrating. Because July 4th, you were still in slavery. June 19th, they had set you free. Now, why don't y'all act like free folk and give God some praise while you are in this house? I ain't gonna let you go till you break out in praise. Because the devil wants to stop you, but you got to break out in praise. Are y'all here? Well, I sit there and I listen to Aaron as he did in worship and praise. And some of y'all said, huh? The more he poured it in, huh? I said, eventually they're going to have to set a strike of fire here in a minute. They kept saying, huh? He kept saying, God, and y'all kept saying, huh? So finally I said, maybe Evan will come up here, take her shoes off, and do something. And then he said, well, Jesus on the main line. I said, that's going to get it right there. And finally he said, Jesus on the main line, tell him what you want. Y'all start standing up praising God. There ought to come a time in your life when you ought to be tired of the devil stealing your joy and stealing your peace and start praising God in the midst of your situation. So can I get y'all to lose your mind for just 1 second and give God praise? I'm almost done. That's 50 seconds. Can I give you another second to give them some praise? I said, break out in praise. This might not be your church. They may not act like that in your church. I'm sorry, but that's how we act up here. When you think about the goodness of God and all he's done for us, look what God has brought you from. Look where you was when you was a child, and look at where you are right now. Most all of us in here got more than we've ever had. Living better than we ever lived. Living in a house that our mom and daddy couldn't afford. And y'all gonna sit on your behind and not give God some praise? Can y'all say amen here? Can you say amen here? I'm living in houses my mom and daddy couldn't live in. But they made a way for me to live there. And I need somebody to praise your mom and your daddy for making a way for you to be where you are right now. So can you put your hand together? Can y'all holler in here? Break out. Break out. Break out. Break out. Break out in praise. Well, let me try to. Let me try to catch y'all. Let y'all catch up with me. Got to break out in praise. Listen, listen, listen. Jesus, the Son of God, he never began his earthly ministry until he had a fight with the devil. You are not going to get a breakthrough until you learn how to fight the devil. Oh, now, if Jesus had to fight him, you're going to have to fight. You got to give him a fight. Matter of fact, I got word to support what I'm saying. Matthew 3, 16 and 17, it says right there, and Jesus, after his baptism, Jesus came up to the water. The heaven was open, and he saw a spirit of God descending like a dove, settling on him. 17 says what? And a voice from heaven said, this is my son in whom I'm well pleased. Then listen now, this is a great celebration. Then he got to chapter 4 and verse 1. Then Jesus was led by the Spirit in the wilderness to be tempted there by the devil. Y'all didn't hear I said. After a celebration, the devil showed up. Are y'all here? And he's going to show up on your pew right now. But then, verse 11, then the devil went away and the angels came and took care of Jesus. The devil will mess you up, but God will straighten up what the devil messes up. I'm trying to get you off the edge today. Because I'm telling you, y'all better hear me out. Life can life you. And when life life you, you will be about to lose your mind. Y'all ain't be honest right here. I said life can life you. And life will make you want to take your life. But I came to tell you right now, when the devil comes to tempt you, God is able to come and care for you. Things that may not be happening as quickly as you want, but stand in faith like Abraham did. Believe that God will fulfill his promise. I feel so good today. Because the reason I feel so good here, because a change is coming. My God, I see a change is coming in the church. And it ain't got nothing to do with those seats you sitting on. A change is coming. Matter of fact, it's already got started. Y'all just don't see what's happening. But you got the promise of God. And you got to stand on that promise. Romans chapter 4, I'm reading all Bible today. Verse 20 and 21, the Bible says Abraham never wavered in believing God's promise. In fact, his faith grew stronger in this, that he brought glory to God. And being fully persuaded that he, whatever he said, fully convinced that God is able to do whatever he promises. Yes, I believe today. That whatever God promised, God's going to do what he said. I'm sanctified happy today. And I want to tell somebody today, quit focusing on what you're going through. And begin focusing on what you're going to. Can I say that one more time? Stop focusing on what you're going through. And begin focusing on what you're going to. Well, since you didn't like that, I got something else to say. Quit focusing on what you have. And begin to look what is what you're about to have. Can I say it one more time? Stop looking at what you have and begin to look at what you're going to have. Quit looking at everything against you and start looking at everything that's for you. You got more for you than you have against you. Adam preached better than y'all said amen. You can't stop me from believing God. I don't care who don't believe him, I still believe him. I believe he'll do whatever he said he'll do. Yes, he will. Now, that's my introduction. That's my introduction. Now, let me give you my little sermon. I done gave y'all the introduction. And some of y'all ain't said amen yet. So maybe you'll say amen in the sermon. That's the introduction. Introduction is, the sermon says Psalm 66. And 12. And said, you put a leader over our heads. We went through the fire and went through the flood. But you brought us to a great place of abundance. Well, y'all ain't got it yet. Matter of fact, the choir director in Psalms 26 and 6, before he got to verse 12, he said, you ought to shout praises to God. He said, sing about the glory of his name. He said, tell the world how glorious your God is. Say to God, how awesome is his deeds. Everything on earth ought to worship you. Y'all, I say everything ought to worship God. They're going to sing praises, going to shout his name. He said, come and see. Verse 4 said, come and see what our God has done. Awesome miracles that he has performed. Made a dry path in a Red Sea. Ain't he all right? Gave power to those that were weak. He washed over everybody. Verse 8 said, let the whole world bless our God. Sing praises to our God. Then he said, verse 12 said, I brought a leader and put him over you. And I had him to ride over your head. I sent fire, but fire is temporary. Flood is temporary. Your setbacks are positioning you for a comeback. Your struggle will not last forever. Your pain is not permanent pain. Your pain is just temporary. Don't judge me by where I am, because you don't see where I'm going. You can talk about me all you want to, but you don't see what I'm going. I'm going somewhere. Do I have anybody going with me? The old song says, if I can get somebody to lift Jesus, the deacon, can I get you to lift him high? That men may see what God is about to do in this church right now. Can I get under my say, this is my season? I'm done. Y'all ain't came to pray. I'm done now. Your miracle is in the making. Yvonne, Philippians 1:6 says, listen, be confident that the very thing that he has begun, the good work in you, will continue his work until he finally finished on the day of Jesus Christ. What God has started, God is about to perform. He's going to keep his word, y'all. Whatever he said, God's going to do it. Matter of fact, as I take my seat, it's almost payday. Are y'all hear that? I said almost payday. Almost payday. What he started, he's going to perform. You say, how you know it's payday? I'll tell you why it is. It's payday because Galatians 6:9 says, let us not be weary. Don't get tired and do good and good. For in due season, you're going to reap. If you don't lose heart, if you don't give up, if you don't hang on in there, a harvest is on the way. The word do means is owed to you. Are y'all here? Paul said, because you've been faithful, it's payday. Good morning, St. Luke. I'm done with my little message. It's payday. It's your due season. God is about to do a blessing in your family, in your finances, and in this church. It's payday. I'm shouting because it's payday. My first point was standing on the edge of a breakthrough. Now, what's the second point? Well, my third point is standing on the edge of a breakthrough. Ain't he all right? The first one is just like the third one. So if you can't get it the first time, you might get it the second time. You don't get it the second time, you might do it the third time. I'm standing on the edge of a breakthrough. Tell yourself your best days are ahead. Y'all talk to yourself, my best days are ahead of me. Tells that God is able to fulfill every word that's been spoken over you. Talk back to me. You are closer than you think. Ain't he all right? Your best days will is yet to come. You ain't seen nothing yet. When God get through with you, you ain't gonna look like you look today. God's gonna take you to a higher level than you ever been before. I'm just gonna use Willie, because Willie's my friend. And I can talk to Willie, I can talk about Willie. And he's gonna talk back to me. God's about to do something, and Willie and Georgette, he's gonna stay standing on the edge of a breakthrough. Your best days are ahead of you. Ain't he all right? You say, how you gonna tell a man that had three strokes? I'm gonna tell him again, your best days are ahead of you. Ain't he all right? You're closer than you think. I dare y'all to bless Willie. If y'all point over there at Willie, if you ain't ashamed to bless somebody else, you gotta learn how to bless somebody else. If you learn to bless somebody else, he might bless you. I dare y'all to point at Willie and tell Willie your best days are ahead of you. You ain't seen nothing yet. Ain't he all right? God said it. That settles it. Ain't he all right? If you point toward Willie with one hand, God's pointing back at you with the other nine fingers. If I bless him, God's going to bless me. Ain't he all right? Can you point that Willie? Ain't he all right? Tell Willie it's going to be all right. Willie,
A blessing is on the way. Willie, you're the head of your blessing. Ain't he all right? Say yes. Say yes. Say yes. Yes. Now we're all left here. Can you put around your arm around somebody that's sitting next to you? I hope it ain't somebody you don't like. Tell that person, your best days are ahead of you. Your dreams about to come to pass. You're closer than you think. Any all right? I'm done here. I got to tell somebody. I got to tell somebody. Any all right? Any all right? I got one more thing. I got one more thing I got to get y'all to do. Practice your coming out shout. Y'all ain't got it. I said practice your coming out shout. Y'all ain't doing nothing. You got to practice your coming out shout. Practice your coming out shout. Ain't he all right? Hey, yeah. You got to practice your coming out shout. Reason why you ain't got healed yet. Because you won't get up off your behind and practice your coming out shout. I dare y'all to stand up in here and practice your coming out shout. Put your hand together. Stomp your feet. Holler if you want to. Can y'all practice? I know something. I know something better than that. I know something better than that. Why not go ahead and praise God like you already came out? Come on, you gotta practice it like you already came out. Practice that you already got. Come on, I'm gonna give you one more minute and we're done. It's just 10:20. You got to practice your coming out shout. You can holler if you want to. You can run if you want to. You can clap your hand, whatever it does. You got to practice your coming out. You got to act like you already got it. Are y'all here today? Let me tell y'all, I know some stuff. I know what God can do. The reason I said Willie, and I didn't have Willie in my notes. Because what I want to do with Willie, because if it starts with Willie, it's going to go to Brandon. Y'all ain't saying nothing. I said it's going to bless Brandon and his family. Because when the dad is leading right, the family going to follow right. Ain't he all right? Say amen. I'm done now. Because I know what God will do for us. Willie and Georgetta mates. Are y'all here? Georgia lost her job years ago. Good job. Good job. Good benefits. They ain't miss no meals. They ain't miss no house notes. They done bought a couple of cars. Y'all ain't say amen here. You gotta learn how to praise God. They pay their tithes. I'm sorry. And God has made a way. God put them on a, y'all hold it a minute. God put them on a hot dog truck. You can hardly make money on a hot dog truck. They make money off hot dogs. I said they make money on hot dogs. God'll take a hot dog. God'll take a hot dog. Y'all leave. She all right, leave her alone. She all right. Y'all ain't gotta hold you. God'll take a hot dog and make you a millionaire. Y'all ain't said amen in here. Won't he do it? Won't he do it? You all say yes, he will. These are living witnesses of what God can do. Yes, he will.
I'm done. The door of the church is open. I make sure I read something always. And I saw yesterday, Kenny Jones, I saw a conversation on a golf course. And they was interviewing some African-American men. And they said, an interview said, what is a black man's job? And they went through all about 10 or 20 black men. What a black man. They said, what a black man's job? He said, well, what is your? He said, I'm a lawyer. Another said, I'm a doctor. Another said, I'm a CEO of 10 businesses. You want to know what a black man, every one of them had something they were doing. You want to know what a black man's job is? These are black men's jobs. They own businesses. They doing well. See, y'all ought to be clapping for black men. Because we ain't all bad. It's some good black men. It's some good black boys. We need to recognize. Hallelujah. I'm going to get all I can get while I'm here. The door of the church. Because one thing I'm doing, the door's open. I am not going to get to heaven. And Jay West, God takes me around heaven. And he going to show me all this stuff. He said, you could have had that on earth. Some of y'all waiting to get to heaven to get all your stuff when you get to heaven. No, I'm gonna get some mine here. No, don't hate, appreciate, bless somebody else while they getting their blessing. But some of y'all out, that's okay. When you get to heaven, you can go and walk the streets of gold, and he gonna open the door. He gonna show you some stuff. He said, you could have been riding in that. You could have been living in that. But you didn't trust me enough to get what you have. There's a word in season. God bless you. May God keep you today. Lord, the church. If you're here today, will you come? Because there's a word for you. Today is that day. You say, man, I've been trying to make up my mind. Is that the place I want to be? Is this the church I need to be? Well, God just convinced you. Now you got to do what he says. He just convinced you. Today is your day. To get off the edge and step out in the water. God's about to make a move in your family. He's about to make a move in your finances. Demario, he's about to move in your personal life. He's going to make it greater than ever been before. Door of the church is open. Every head bowed, every eye closed. This morning, from the back of it to the floor, wherever you are, will you come give me your hand? Will you come? Give me your hand. Today is the day for you to come to Jesus Christ. You come wherever you are in this building. Nobody is looking at you. They're praying for you, young man, young lady, wherever you are, whoever you are. See, the devil is playing with your mind because you're in your body. But your spirit is already into your tomorrow. And he wants to do something for you right now. But he can't do it until you make a move toward him. And if you come give me your hand, that's a move toward him. If you're here today, will you come? Will you come? Will you come today? While the blood is still running warm in your veins. Don't wait till it's too late. You need to do it right now. Young man, will you come? This is the hour. This is the day for you to give your life to Jesus Christ. Wherever you are, whoever you are, will you come? While Jay West blows something, he's blowing just for you to give you this time to come. And if you sit next to your friend, and you ask your friend, if you would die today, you next to your friend, you next to your loved one, if you really love them, you should want them to put faith in God. You ought to love them enough to tell them, look, man, look, girl, I'll walk down there for you. I'll help you walk down there. If it take you turning your life around, I'm going to give you time. It's important. Move. Because God is moving. He's moving. You can have all the things in this world. Just in this city the other night, people lost everything they had. All went up in smoke. And everything you have can go up in smoke. But if you got God in your life, hope is in God. It's not in the things you have. Hope is in God. I'm going to give you a chance if you're in the back or wherever you are. Jay West doing something. Jay West going to blow something. I don't care what he blow, as long as he blow you off that pew. Come on now, you ought to smile. If Christians can't laugh, I don't know who can laugh. There's a day you to come. Since he's moving. Wake up. Of the glory, goodness of the Lord. Come on, wherever you are. God's been faithful, I tell you. All my life. All my life, he's been. All my life. I'm going to give you one chance. You know, while you're waiting to come stand with him, let me give you a word today. My first cousin, his daughter, Erica Heron, she put something up yesterday. Whenever I read it, it blew my mind to see a young lady wanting to read the Word of God and enjoying God. I'm telling you all, young adults here, you can love God. You can live for God. Just like she's experiencing, I told her, what you're experiencing will be with you your whole life. God's going to bless your family because of you. Who do we have, brother? Chris Williams. Quick, Williams, okay. Yeah, Chris Williams, we're glad for you to come to be a member of this church.
Glad to be here.
Glad to be here. Bless you. Do you believe that Jesus the Christ is the Son of the living God?
Yes, sir.
Let your church say amen to that.
Amen.
Know what he said? I'm glad to be here. So y'all ought to be glad to hear. Why don't you stand there? Hallelujah. As you go back to your seat, she'll talk to you after church, and we'll bless you even more. Hallelujah today. Great God, great God, great. Come on. God is such an awesome God. My God. I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now. Gone too far, been too long. He done kept me too long for me to turn around now. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. There's a word in this season as we go through this summer breeze. Amen. Amen. Now, when you first heard summer breeze, what did you think about? Come on, KT, let's see. What did y'all? What's our church of y'all really?
Summer breeze all in my mind.
See that? I see y'all head. I see your head. Now turn it up a little louder because y'all know who it is. You turn it up a little bit louder, they're going to stand up. You can stand up. Don't look at nobody. You can stand up because y'all know what it is. Don't come to church act like y'all ain't never heard of it. The eyes of the brothers. She said, I heard it this morning. That's what y'all thought.
Blowing through the jasmine in my mind.
Yeah. Now see that, I know y'all gonna stand. I knew it. You can still be saved. It's okay. It's okay. You can still be saved.
Blowing through the jasmine in my mind.
Y'all sung it last night. Why you can't sing it now? Now, then cut it off, cut it off. Stop. Don't, whatever you did last week, don't do it now. Stop it. It's over. God bless you. If Christians can't laugh, I don't know who can. We ought to be able to enjoy life. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. We cannot be sad. Life is too short. I mean, people are dying as never died before. And they're not dying old, they're dying young. You need to enjoy life while you got a chance. As the deacons come, as they come, as we serve this morning, the first Sunday in this month of July, what a great day to come. Bible says that everyone that believes in Jesus Christ examine themselves as you pray today. Confess your own sins before you eat and drink. Can you bow your head today? Father, forgive us of our sins of omission as well as commission. Thank you for Jesus shed his blood, his broken body. God, we thank you for that today. We do this now in remembrance of me. We're not ever worthy to eat and drink, but because our belief in Jesus Christ, he makes us worthy. Thank you right now. In Jesus' name, amen. He took the bread, he blessed it. He said, this is my body. He said, eat this. Do this in remembrance of me as we all eat together in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. The cup of the New Testament, this is my blood. He said, drink this. Do this in remembrance of me as we all drink together in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen. Amen. As you can fellowship with somebody this morning and shake hands with someone that's amen. Close to you. Amen. Amen. Precious fountain, precious fountain. Free to all. In thy cross, be my Savior forever, glory forever. Fill my soul. Emphasis on two or three of the announcements that you see on the screen. One is the women ministry. I don't know if that was there or not. We'll have a prayer breakfast on August the 3rd. I believe that's Saturday, August the 3rd, first Saturday. And so we want at least 100 women to be in participation of this great day for women in our church. I think they'll have war clothes on. So you wear your fatigue. You wear your stuff just like Tania got on. That's what they got, I think. Yeah, they're going to have that on that Saturday. Amen. Amen. And they're going to have a great day, and we pray that you all certainly will be upon all women, all ladies, young and old. It's not a senior meeting. It's young and old. Amen. It's a young and old. Young, middle-aged, you come and to be a part of this prayer breakfast. Also, Wednesday night, our young adult, Thrive Ministry. They're going to have a Bible study that's called, let's talk about it. Yeah, let's talk about it. Ain't that something? Praise God for them. Amen. Praise God for them. Amen. Any other information, you see Liz and Brandon Bullock, you certainly be blessed today to be a part of that ministry
for young adults. Amen. And they need it. They need each other. And I'm not going to be there. Sorry. It's not for me. It's for young adults. Amen. They don't need me hanging around there. No, and I'm not either. Amen. They can handle it. God, amen. Amen. So you stay at home and pray like I do. Just pray for them. And those are two things. And also next Sunday is our Seed Sunday. We do it 20 twice a year. We do it in July. We do it in November. Just an opportunity that you can give. We don't sell things. We don't do all those things to collect money for the church. We don't do it. We haven't done it in 35 years. We're not going to start it now. But God has blessed us. And because of you, because the blessings are here. So just come and give extra to your tithe, and you'll see how God's going to blow up what we have. Amen. Can you do that on next Sunday? You can do it starting tomorrow. You can still start it today. You ain't got to wait next Sunday. Go on and do it now and be blessed of God. God bless you. May God keep you. Ashley, is that you? Good to see you. Let us all stand. Good. These young adult people, they are somebody. I'm telling you, they are. God, I gave them what you gave me. And I pray if we walk away from this place, we walk away in love with you. Knowing that, God, the best is ahead of us. What we've been dreaming is going to come to pass. You ain't seen nothing yet. Thank you right now, God. We give you praise and we give you glory. In Jesus' name. Now to him who's able to keep you from falling, present you faultless in the presence of Almighty God. To the only wise God, our Savior, through Jesus Christ our Lord, his power, dominion, both now and forevermore. And all the people of God said, amen. Don't these men look good?